The U.S. Navy has made a major advancement in maritime combat readiness by successfully demonstrating the Transportable Re-Arming Mechanism, or TRAM, on a warship in open waters for the first time. The landmark trial occurred on October 11th off the coast of San Diego, where sailors aboard the Ticonderoga-class cruiser USS Chosin, CG-65, utilized the hydraulically powered TRAM device to load an empty missile canister into the ship's Mark 41 Vertical Launching System, VLS. During the at-sea demonstration, the USS Chosin linked up with the USNS Washington Chambers, T-AKE-11, a Military Sealift Command dry cargo and ammunition ship. The supply vessel transferred the missile canister via cables to the cruiser, where the TRAM device moved the canister along a rail system, tilted it vertically, and precisely lowered it into a VLS cell using its advanced cable and pulley system. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how TRAM will fundamentally change the way the U.S. Navy fights future wars. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The Mark 41 VLS is a key asset of American warships. The cells can be used to deploy a variety of different kinds of weapons, like ESSM, or Evolved Sea Sparrow Missile, for air defense, Tomahawk's cruise missile, RUM-139A VL ASROC for anti-submarine warfare, as well as standard series air defense missiles like SM-2 and SM-3. So, these cells accommodate both offensive and defensive weapons. American Ticonderoga-class has 122, whereas Arleigh Burke-class has 96 of these cells. Currently, a warship needs to return to port or reach a safe, calm harbor where it can reload its VLS from a support ship and be a safe distance from threats from adversaries. For example, in the Pacific theater, the U.S. Navy warship will have to sail to Guam or even Yokosuka or Hawaii or maybe Australia. This means that ships will be out of the fight for days or weeks, with time lost to transit, but also with the added potential enemy threats from air or surface. Tim Barnard, director of the NAVSEA Technology Office, stressed the strategic advantage this capability provides. Deploying TRAM into the Military Sealift Command logistics fleet would enable combatants to remain in theater while reloading their VLS missile launchers, instead of having to travel long distances to a port, greatly expanding the volume and tempo of long-range fires and the U.S. Navy's advantage over adversaries. TRAM, in its current form, is designed to work with existing U.S. Navy at-sea replenishment ships and can reload VLS cells on surface ships in conditions up to Sea State 5. The system employs an articulated crane capable of lifting and rotating a missile canister vertically for lowering it into the launcher cell. According to the Beaufort scale, Sea State 5 involves moderate winds of 17 to 21 knots and waves ranging from 6 to 8 feet. Auxiliary ships like the fleet of T-AKEs and LMSR vessels with systems like TRAM could be positioned tactically, and these could be used to resupply warships like Arleigh Burke-class destroyers, Ticonderoga-class cruisers, and Zumwalt-class destroyers. It's to be noted here that a congressional subcommittee stated that the U.S. Navy is not moving fast enough to figure out how to better push munitions to its ships at sea and wants to know what's being done to fix the problem. A planned briefing on this has to be provided to the House Committee on Armed Services no later than February 15, 2025. As per figures provided by the U.S. Navy, In fiscal year 2023, the service allocated $3.9 million in research, test, development, and evaluation, RDT&E funds, for what's known as the Modular Transportable Re-Arming Mechanism, or TRAM, system, with another $12.4 million set aside for fiscal year 2024. It's uncertain if any funds have been requested for fiscal year 2025. Over the past few years, multiple VLS reloading experiments have been carried out. In 2022, a Military Sealift Command-sponsored reloading test paired USS Spruance, DDG-111, with the offshore support vessel, MV Ocean, as a test platform to support logistics experimentation for fuel, stores, passengers, and ordnance delivery. Commander Robertson stated that in 2021, the dry cargo ship USNS Amelia Earhart, T-AKE-6, and guided missile destroyer USS John S. McCain, DDG-56, experimented with VLS reloading at sea. That was preceded in 2019 by two separate VLS reloading tests, which were pierside and protected harbor only. There were no open ocean events. 3 years earlier, in 2016, the Navy put VLS reloading to the test with initial experimentation with the auxiliary ship USNS Bob Hope, TAKR-300, and the guided missile cruiser USS Bunker Hill, CG-52. This test was highly anticipated, drawing significant interest from Congress. While several tests have been carried out earlier, conducting the test at sea posed a much greater challenge due to its increased complexity. Near-peer rivals like China and Russia have been working on ways to counter the might of the U.S. Navy. They've deployed different types of anti-ship and land attack missiles, defending against which will require U.S. Navy ships to launch a number of interceptor missiles like SM-3 and SM-6. In some cases, multiple interceptor missiles need to be fired against a single incoming threat. It's not hard to see that the U.S. Navy needs to have all its warships loaded with optimum firepower in a high-intensity conflict. If TRAM proves fully successful and is deployed to the fleet, it will allow Mark 41 vertical launch system weapon cells to be reloaded much quicker. The criticality of this test can be ascertained by the fact that the Secretary of the U.S. Navy was in attendance and he declared it a huge success. Today we proved just how game-changing TRAM truly is, and what a powerful deterrent it will be to our competitors, he said. This demonstration marks a key milestone on the path to perfecting this capability and fielding it for sustained operations at sea.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.